When I was a child, my family used to go all kinds of different places on vacations, family vacations. We just loved it. We would go camping in Yosemite. We'd go to Arizona to the Grand Canyon. And I remember being in the local mountains where the air was nice and fresh and you could smell the pine trees and it was great. And then we would start heading down the mountain. And you would go around this one corner where all of a sudden you could see the LA Basin. And I remember just feeling like my heart was about to just drop because you couldn't see the bottom of the valley. All you saw was smog. And it looked like this, just a cloud of just bleh, it was gross. And I remember thinking, and we have to go down the mountain and go back to that. And I was like, I wanted to stay up here in the mountains where it's nice and clean. I didn't want to have to go back down there. I don't really remember anybody talking about what to do about the smog back then. It almost was an accepted part of life for a while. It just felt like, well, it's just smog, it's just LA. LA is a smoggy place. You didn't question it because you didn't know that there was anything better. Going to elementary school was kind of a nightmare because this was back in the 1970s. And we would have these smog alerts. On smog alert days, I felt like my lungs were burning. It was hard to breathe, and it just felt like a chemical burning. So by the time I graduated high school in 1981, it was a lot better. And it was starting to feel more hopeful that the smog alerts are gonna be a thing of the past pretty soon. You could tell things were getting better because you could start to see the visible part of the smog was going away. Then, I don't know what happened. It just seems like the progress we had made stopped for a while. And people were all focused on, well, you can see the mountains now. But now that the visible part was better, it was hard to convince people that the invisible part, which is the dangerous part, was still there. A lot of people don't know, when they think of California, they don't think of an oil state. When you think of an oil state, you think of Alaska or Texas. But California was actually one of the biggest producers of oil, and still is. This map shows you where all the oil wells are in California, oil and gas wells. And if you take a look at this map, people don't realize how extensive it is. And the fact that many of them are in major metropolitan areas. People don't know that they're living right on top of oil fields. Now the visible part of the smog is starting to come back. And that really has me concerned because it's like, where is this smog coming from? I thought we had taken care of this. Something has happened where we're going backwards. So what happened? We have the worst air quality in the country. And so something is obviously not working. And we need to move forward and we need to fix this.